In this short video, I am going to introduce you to the gas train or the boiler. Okay, so this is the water, small water tube boiler. So up in here, you can see there's a gas in there. It said it is 2.5 psi natural gas coming in. So you have a sort of valve in there. Now, and then next one, you can see this one, that is a pressure reducing valve. So when you burn natural gas, the boiler only need half a psi, but just a few kPa. So that means you have to reduce it from 2.5 psi to down to a half a psi something. So that is your reducer. After this, you can see there are two, or maybe down a little bit, two automatic gas valve. Okay, the programmer will start this automatic gas valve. Now on the bottom there, you see in here, that is low gas pressure cutout. And the other side is a high gas pressure cutout. On the right hand side, that's another stop valve before you reach the fan of the furnace. Okay, now, so the low gas pressure cutout is when the inlet gas is not high enough, so it shut the boiler off. Now, so the other side is a high gas pressure cutout. So if the pressure near the furnace, the funnel furnace, is too high, so that means you have a chance got a too rich natural gas, so and we will have explosion. So before it happen like that, we're gonna shut the boiler off first. Okay, now, so there's another sort of valve there, and then let's say we go to the fan, so that go to the fan in here for the natural gas, so the natural gas. Now you can see this one is the metering, a butterfly valve for controlling the gas. After this, it just go into the boiler. Okay, now the butterfly valve is controlled by a modulating motor. So that modulating motor is hooked up to the butterfly gas valve down, and that is your damper on the top. Now, so the modulating motor is in turn controlled by the programmer, which is this thing, that's the programmer. Okay, now let's take a look on the fan, and then there's some other thing on the fan. So you see this one, it's called a frame scanner. It will the circuit will close if this the scanner see frame inside there. If you lose your frame, the frame scanner will open the circuit, and then the boiler will drop. Now on the left there, you see we have an igniter. So this one is your transformer, and that is your igniter. You see, igniter, they produce spark. There is a small piece of gas line coming in here. Now let's follow this. That is called just a pilot gas. So pilot gas light, just a little bit of gas, and then you have spark, and then you have the pilot light. Okay. Now let's go back to the fun there. Take a look at the pilot gas valve. So the pilot gas valve, this is the pilot gas. You go through there, there is a shut off valve there. And when you go over there, there is another pressure reducer in here, reducer of pressure a little bit. And then you have the solenoid valve. The solenoid valve is the on-off valve. So the programmer will tell the solenoid valve to open up or close at the right time. So, okay. So that is your gas train. Now let me zoom out a little bit, and then you can see the whole thing. Okay. Now zoom out here, and then we can see. Now on the inlet, there's a shut-off valve. And then next, you see the pressure reducer, and then you have two automatic gas valve. And on the left there, on the bottom left, you have a low gas pressure cutout. On the right there, that is high gas pressure cut out, another sort of valve there, another sort of valve, and then you go to the fun, go to the fun, you have the butterfly valve, and then the gas go in. Now, and then the pilot line, the pilot line is a bench out from the fun. And now, if I see in here, you might be able to see the pilot. Now, you see the pilot there, they go through, you have a pressure reducer there, and a solenoid valve. And then you go through there, and then go through this, and you go to the fun of the boiler, and then hook up with the spark, the igniter, which produce spark, and used to start the boiler.